Michael C. Anthony.
Great to see you all. Everybody, put your hands out like this. Point your thumbs down and cross your arms. Now, interlock your fingers like this. Make sure your thumbs are pointed down. Make sure your neighbor's thumbs are pointed straight down. Okay. And get ready for the next move. You ready? Do this. Give yourselves a round of applause. Why was I able to raise my thumbs and you weren't? Not because I'm double-jointed, but because I acted slightly different than you did. I did, and I'll show you exactly what I did in a little while. But the point of that is that sometimes the slightest shift in our behavior can make all the difference in the world. My program today is called Use Your Brain for a Change. By a change, I mean a change in the way you currently run your mind. A change in the way you connect the dots from a thought to a result. How many people here believe in mind reading? Raise your hand. Nobody? Good. How many people here believe in psychic powers? Raise your hand. Well, here's a good one. How many people here believe in a phenomenon known as deja vu? Raise your hand. Here's another good one. How many people here believe in a phenomenon known as deja vu? Raise your hand. If you believe in telekinesis, raise my hand. All right, what's your first name?
Leslie.
Leslie. That's correct. Leslie, do me a favor. Think of a number between 1 and 100. Now, when you think of this number, be very careful not to move your mouth. Some people will give me small nonverbal cues as to the number they're thinking of. I don't want you to do that, Leslie. I was doing this with a woman a little while ago in Ohio, and I said, think of a number between 1 and 100. Be very careful not to move your mouth. She went like this. 31. I said, is the number 31? She said, how could you possibly know? Okay, so Leslie, you were thinking of a number. Come on up here for us for 1 second. Okay, you're going to take a step right back to where you were. Come on right up. I'm just going to hand this to you. For the first time, name the number you're thinking of. Sorry? 6. Let's be honest. There's no way I should possibly be able to know which number you thought of, correct? Okay, nobody else here should be able to know which number you thought of, correct? In a really loud voice, read everything that I wrote on that pad of paper. Really loudly.
Leslie will think of the number 6.
Give her a big round of applause. All right, thank you. James Allen, the author of the book As a Man Thinketh, said, the visions that you glorify in your mind, the ideas you hold close to your heart, this you will build your life upon, this you will become. So my question to you is, what's under your magnifying glass? Are there times when you tend to lean in a direction where you're focusing on things that are negative? And more importantly, how do you change that? How do you go from a negative thought to a positive thought? You change the channel. What do you mean change the channel? Just like when you're watching something on TV that you don't like, you take out the remote and you change the channel. We can do the exact same thing with our minds. We simply think of something else. Everybody close your eyes for a moment. I want you all to think of a tomato. Think of a tomato. No particular type of tomato, any kind of tomato you can think of. Okay, open your eyes. And close your eyes again. Now think of a horse. And open your eyes. You just change the channel. That is all you need to do to go from a negative thought to a positive one. You simply think of something else. We only have room for one thought in our mind at a time, and it's up to us to make it a good one. I'm going to have you choose a card here, Dan. Now, I'm going to be honest with you. A lot of people who see me do things with the cards, they think that I've got this weird ability to make somebody choose any card I want them to pick. When you pick this card, Dan, don't let me persuade you at all. All right? You make sure you take the card that you want. Okay, whichever one looks good. Slide one out of the deck for me.
I think I want this one.
Okay. Can you imagine if it was that stupid? Give me this back. Okay. Anyone you want. Show it around the room. I'm looking away. Okay. I'm going to have you place that back in the deck, Dan, wherever you want to go. Perfect. 31 from the top.
Exactly.
Just kidding. It was actually 32.
Sorry.
All right. Here's what's going to happen. Dan, you and I are going to have a race to try to find your selected card. You know what the card is, though, right?
I guess.
Okay, and I've got no idea. In a moment, I'm going to give you the pack of cards like this. You're going to hold them in your hands. And when I say go, you're going to race through the cards as quick as you can. I simply want you to try and pull your card out of the pack before I do. That's not it, is it?
No.
That would have been cool, though.
That would have been great.
That would have been great, I know. So that's all you need to do, Dan. You're going to go through the cards as fast as you can. As soon as you find your card, just pull it out of the deck and say, I got it. Beat me to the card. While you're holding the cards, I'm going to be going through as well with my hands saying, is that your card? Is that your card? I'm going to try and beat you to it. Are you ready?
Yep.
You excited? Okay, don't start without me. Ready? One. You can use both hands. One, two, three, and go as quick as you possibly can there, Dan. Give me a chance. Is that it there?
Yep.
No, really? Okay, give me a shot at it. Right here. Yep. Seriously. Okay, don't go by it. Is this it here, Dan?
No.
Keep going through there. I got it. Is this it?
No.
Keep going through there.
Because the card's not in there. Yeah.
Give him a big round of applause. Have a seat, guys. Thank you.